actually live now. So welcome to Stress Bay in the Highlands and to our online house concert, which is hosted by Chamber Music Scotland. And we are extremely grateful to Chamber Music Scotland for providing this platform for musicians whose work has all been cancelled due to the pandemic. And I guess we're all housebound and unable to perform in regular concert halls. So it's been a real boost for me to have this this project to prepare for. There's a lot to be said for having a goal and a focus. So despite the horror and the uncertainty of the global situation, I feel very lucky indeed to be in self-isolation here with my partner Hamish Napier in his home in Strathspey. So we're right now in his grandmother's house, the front room of his grandmother's. And that's right next door to Hamish's parents, which is where Hamish grew up since he was born, I guess, yeah. So there's a lot to be thankful for because there's just, yeah, beautiful scenery around. And especially with the knowledge that, that so many people are suffering around the world. So, yeah, I know that we're all deeply grateful to the NHS and the care workers and all around the world. And that's quite evident in the Clap for Carers that happens every Thursday, 8 o'clock, I'm sure you're all aware, where everyone goes out in the street onto their doorsteps and claps and bangs their pots and pans. And actually what's happened is musicians have been going out and playing music, which has been wonderful. And in the first few weeks, there was a sort of anthem that emerged, which is, it turns out this piece was the very first tune that I ever learnt on my second instrument. So actually, I'd like to kick off this concert with a dedicated piece for the NHS and for our carers. And for that, I'd like to, with great pleasure, introduce Hamish Napier to come and join me.
Hello, how's it going?
So this is my second instrument, it's a musical saw. Dedicated to our frontline workers and the NHS. Thank you, Hamish. Hamish will be back in the second half of this concert to play some tunes of his own. So when I left Edinburgh, nearly 6 weeks ago now, I couldn't imagine how long I'd be away for, and I certainly wasn't thinking of performing anytime soon, and I certainly wasn't thinking of playing a solo cello concert. So putting this programme together has been very interesting, and it's been a really fun process. So we have what I think is a lovely programme for you. So the concert, and in its basic structure, is the first half will be solo cello, and the second half will be with Hamish joining us. And the whole programme will be about an hour in total. So just for you to know, when you're taking a break, that is. And when I left home, I guess I grabbed a massive pile of music, thinking that maybe this is a good time to kind of tackle some of these pieces that basically I've never even opened some of this music. And I thought it'd be great to look at them. And one of these books was a book of Paganini caprices. And for those of you who don't know, the caprices are a set of fiendishly difficult pieces for violin. And so this book is an arrangement for cello. And I just have to say that when I opened the book, I barely could get past the first bar of any of them. So I was relieved when I found this one. I came across this one and I thought, actually, this would be a great one to open the concert with, because it's got a sort of fanfare-like quality. So I thought that would be fun. But I guess above all, the main reason I liked it was that it's short. It's actually under 2 minutes. So this is Paganini's Caprice number 14 in G. Interspersed with Bach chorales, which I thought was lovely. Second half was Taverner and Eisenwaltz. But Alistair asked if I would think about maybe a small, short little solo cello piece to go in between the two choral ones in the second half. And I did some research and I came across this solo sonata by Isai, who's another fiddle composer, a wonderful violinist in his own right, about 100 years ago. He wrote this, and he wrote it at the same time as all his violin sonatas. But it turns out he was a talented cellist as well, which is quite rare to have a cellist and a violinist all packaged up in one person. So I thought this particular sonata, it has a middle movement called intermezzo. It's also rather short. It's like 3-4 minutes. And there's something about it that's quite like Bach as well, so I thought that would complement the programme very well. So I'm going to play for you this intermezzo. It's the middle movement of Isai's solo cello sonata. That was Isai's intermezzo from his solo sonata. As a nod to Alistair from the Edinburgh Singers, I thought it'd be nice to include the Bach here too. There's many reasons to include the Bach, in fact. The Bach's solo suites are staple diet for every cellist, but the suite is particularly special for me, and I guess many of you might recognise it from the prelude from the film from 2003, Master and Commander. So I'm going to play the whole suite for you, and it's about 17 minutes long. There's six movements. There's a prelude, there's an allemande, followed by courant, saraband, two minuets, and it finishes with a gigue. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Suite number one in G. Now before Hamish joins me for the rest of the program, I'd like to play you one more piece, and this one is inspired by my colleagues at the Scottish Chamber Orchestra. And for those of you who don't know me, I've been a member of the SCO for 26 years now, and I have to say that I'm really missing them all very much right now. So I have picked a piece which is one of our firm favourites in the orchestra. Mm-hmm. And I guess I was introduced to this arrangement for five cellos by one of my lovely cellists in NIOS, in the Youth Orchestra, National Youth Orchestra of Scotland. So thank you to Sandy Scott Brown for this recommendation. And I started by layering up the parts on my loop pedal, but actually I realised it just takes too long to do it live. So I've actually pre-recorded four of the parts and I'm just going to play one part live. And I guess it almost feels like I'm playing with my pals, but Hamish here is going to set them off. So this is the prelude from Grieg's Holberg Suite. 't know Hamish, he is a very talented flute, whistle, piano player, singer and composer, and he's just released his third album. He's looking very embarrassed.
I could press the play button too.
And actually his third album, the third solo album, was only released like 2 days after lockdown, so he had a lockdown launch party here in Strathspey, which is great fun.
Yeah.
The first album was, it's all his albums are to do with this area, the lovely Strathspey area. So the river, which is just outside, the railway, which is an old steam railway, and the third one was the woods. And there's two more albums in the offing. Anyway, last autumn, we were both very lucky to be invited to the Small Halls Festival in Skye, which is run by Mary Lewis and Sarah Bain, who are the most incredible team. And it's really an incredible festival. It happens in November when, the deepest, darkest time. Anyway, it was there at this festival that I learned my first Strathspey. And since we are now in the heart of Strathspey, I thought this would be a good time to play it for you. So this is John Stephen of Chance Inn, and we're going to follow that with one of Hamish's own Strathspeys, and it's called Windsong. And Windsong was written for his pal Mike Vass. It was written actually on Mike Vass's family yacht, wasn't it? And the name of the yacht is the same as the song, so it's Windsong. So yeah, here we have. There's a wonderful fiddle player called Duncan Chisholm, and Hamish and I were absolutely delighted to be invited along to play on his last album, and that was called Sandwood, and actually it won an award at the Scottish Trad Awards in 2018. And on this album Hamish wrote a lovely slow air called Barshanavid, which actually also means Sandwood Bay. And actually we decided last summer to make a little pilgrimage up there, didn't we? And for those of you who don't know where Sandwood Bay is, it is in the very northwest of Scotland, in the very northwestern tip. It truly is the most beautiful beach I've ever seen. And it's a good long walk in.
2 hours or something, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, 2 hours of walk in, and even the walk in was beautiful. Mm. And we ended up taking a dip in the sea. We had a little picnic. And what did we find on the beach?
Yeah, we found a massive whale skull, actually, about the size of a couch. A fin whale, wasn't it?
Yeah. And so it had been washed up probably a year ago. So, but I ended up playing Barshanavid on sitting on the whale skull playing the saw.
In the sunshine.
It's absolutely glorious. But so I'm not going to play it on the sword just now. I'm going to play it with Hamish on the cello and piano.
And this one's for our good friend Duncan Chisholm. So I'm going to play this one here. This is so funny to play and then not to have it like, yeah, that's it. We've got lots of pheasants running around outside the window here as well. It's quite funny. Yeah, I'm going to play a tune now which I wrote. It's a hornpipe, and for any of the jazz musicians out there, this is a hornpipe which is written to the chords of I Got Rhythm, so it's a rhythm changes tune. And the wooden flute in folk music, you don't always get everybody playing fully chromatic, as in all the black and white notes of the piano. And this is like a tin whistle turned sideways, is how I describe this instrument. But the silver keys on it give me like all the black notes on the piano. And I wrote this tune so that it would include all the notes. So hopefully I play all of them for you. So yeah, this is it's a tune called The Wee Plank, and it was commissioned by a lovely lady, a great singer called Anne Nielsen. And she asked, you wanted a tune written for something in Glasgow. It's called a wee plank, and it's when you hide your cash under your floorboards or in an old armchair. You get a lot of old ladies that do that. And she had a pal, they found, I think it was £20,000 in an armchair once, and she thought, we have to have a tune written about this. So this is a hornpipe called the Wee Plank.
Just want a tune?
Thank you.
Composed by Hamish. It was composed for his second album, The Railway, in which Patsy Reed, wonderful fiddle player, plays this so beautifully. I don't really play it, but anyway, this was written for Jimmy Gray, an old railway man, and he was actually a train driver, and it's in honour of his late wife, who he was very happily married to for 63 years. This is Helen's Song. That was Helen's Song. Oh my goodness, it's that time of the night. We've gone to our final tune. I can't believe it. So anyway, we've had such a good time putting this program together for you, and I'd like to say that it's been, well, I'd like to say you've been a wonderful audience, but in fact, we don't have a clue what kind of audience you've been. We don't even know if anyone's out there. So
it's a few blackbirds and a few pheasants, but that's about it.
So I guess we'll find out afterwards. But would you please, if you can, if you're anywhere near a tappy computery thing, type us a little message to let us know you've been there, and we can say hello. Anyway, we'd like to say a massive thank you to Chamber Music Scotland.
Yeah.
for providing this platform, and also to Richard, who has been an incredible support for the techie side of things. Hamish is pretty techie, but I'm absolutely clueless. So thank you, Richard, for everything. And it's been a lovely process, in fact. And we're very grateful to the organisation for providing this platform, because basically we're all our musicians are now suddenly out of work and nowhere to go, and we've really got nowhere to go, so this is a really lovely thing for us to have done. The concerts themselves are all free, but if you have enjoyed this evening as we have, then any donations are gratefully received, and I think you're able to watch and donate right through the next, normally be the next week, but in fact the next concert that's happening on the platform is not until Wednesday the 13th of May. So if you'd like to keep in touch about the next performance, do sign up for Chamber Music Scotland, their YouTube channel or Facebook or whatever, and you'll find out about that. And also another huge thanks to our NHS and all our caregivers. Yeah. And frontline workers. They're an amazing support to all of us, and thank you for keeping us all well and safe. For those of you who missed it, actually at the beginning of the concert we did a dedication especially for them, so do go back and listen to that. I guess that's it. It's now the last piece.
Put your hands together for Sue and me.
And Hamish Napier. So this last tune is from Hamish's second album, The Railway, and it's kind of like the namesake of it. It's the Strathspey line, is that right? Strathspey line. And I guess when I'm thinking of this railway, it's an old steam railway that passes literally, well, you can't see quite out the window, but we're right on a river, the River Spey, and across, literally right across, about 200 metres away, is the old steam railway past there. So I like to think of, when I'm playing this at least, all the Strathspey whiskey that's transported back and forth along this line. So this is Strathspey line.
And it features some recordings made on the Strathspey Railway, so there's a train pulling off from Broomhill Station here that we're going to kick off with.
Thank you.
thanks again for joining us this evening. But actually, please don't leave us just yet.
Just hang on there.
Hamish and I have had a lot of fun preparing you an encore. Now, normally in orchestral concerts, there are endless bows and loads of curtain calls, and basically audiences need to clap their hands raw until they get an encore. But we actually thought we'd cut to the chase. And we are going to prepare. Well, we're going to give you an encore anyway. So, bear with us. I'm going to leave the room, but don't go away. We'll be back in just a second.
Everyone's thinking, what on earth's going on now?
He's a one-trick pony. One trick is all that horse can do. He does one trick only. It's the prism we saw, so it's real moon. And when he steps into the spotlight, you can feel the heat of his heart come rising. Side to side. See how he prances, the way his hooves just seem to glide. He's just a one-trick pony, that's all he is. But he turns that trick with pride. He makes it look so easy, it looks so clean. He moves like God's immaculate machine. He makes me think about all of these extra moves I make, and all this herky-jerky motion, and the bag of tricks.